everybody for being here with us tonight. It was wonderful to have. Also, a special thank you to those who traveled some at great distances. We actually have guests from Kansas, Ohio, Pennsylvania, California, the great state of Texas, and Panama City, Panama. I'd like to recognize two people that we love so very much, and that is the parents of the groom, Dave and Bonnie Derby, the parents of the groom. I have notes. I'm getting a little old. I need notes. Also wanted to say really was fathers and daughters will understand that when you're blessed with a beautiful baby girl, we all fall in love all over again. We want to protect her and care for her the same as we did her mother. We do things we usually don't do. For me, that was watching the big comfy couch, Dora the Explorer, and Barney. I can still sing Barney song. We'll do that later during karaoke. But as your little princess grows up, you realize soon that you won't always be the only man in her life, that there are these things called boys living on the horizon. And when I told Marissa, I always told her, you need to find a gentleman. Set the bar high. So to me, I thought, saying find a gentleman, it's kind of hard to do nowadays. Didn't think it happened as quickly as it did. But Marissa came to me one day, it's a true story. She was 16 and she goes, Dad, I met this nice guy. Aww. And he's a gentleman. And by the way, he's cute too. So I'm like, oh. So I really wanted to meet this nice gentleman, Chris. And I got to tell you, any of your friends who are single meeting a father for the first time can take a page out of your playbook. He came in, firm handshake, that is very important to me, a firm handshake. Looked me square in the eye, and immediately agreed to all the rules. And then he turned tail, I thought the copper was going to start on fire, he got out of there. But, you know, I have to tell you, I was rather surprised at how quickly I started to trust Chris during their dating time. And over the years, he was a man of his word. He always took care of Marissa, got her home safe. I felt comfortable with him, and I was surprised that I did that so early. Because I know myself, and you know me, Marissa knows me. It's like, yeah, we're here on time, and I'm waiting for you, and I don't want to smell big red gum on your mouth, in your breath. So over the years, I can tell you that, without a doubt, Chris possesses the two qualities that are most important to me as a father. That any father, I think, can only hope that the man his daughter marries will possess, and that is honor and integrity. Chris is an honorable man, he has integrity, and I've seen that for myself, and I am so happy to now call you son. It's been a while. Finally, thank you. Okay, and a little bit from about Marissa. As you all know, Marissa is a wonderful nurse. I have been blessed to be in healthcare for over 25 years, and I know a good nurse when I see it. Marissa is a good nurse who cares about her patients. She's in it for the right reason. And some of you probably know, but maybe not everybody, she has just recently been accepted to nurse practitioner school. We are very, very proud of you. You're going to be a wonderful nurse practitioner. In closing, I wanted to tell you, Chris, you know how I am. We spent a lot of time out at the camp. A very good friend of mine, Vince, who was here tonight, hanging out at the camp in the woods. And you know that I think everything should be camouflaged. I think these should be camouflaged tonight, but that wasn't going to happen. So that's my kind of nerdy thing during, you know, birthdays and Christmas. You're always going to get a gift that's probably going to be camouflaged, so I apologize now. But the more the better, that's what I think. But I want you to know that today I have just given you the most precious gift I have to give, and that is my daughter's hand in marriage. And it's now up to you to love her, honor her, cherish her, and protect her. And I have every confidence that you will. And I want you both to know that Dave, Bonnie, Sandra, and I love you so very much, and we'll always be here with you. during your journey through life. We love you so much.
It is easy to see how the two of you have made it here today, and I am inspired how a relationship as grounded as yours. I love you both, and I am so blessed to know each of you, and I pray that you have a lifetime of happiness. Now, if everyone will raise their glass and cheers to the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Derby.
Trying not to be too dumb or whatever, but oh man, this is fucking. Sorry. Miss Sandra, I apologize. Miss Bonnie knew it was coming. Oh, jeez. I was about to think about what story to tell, and you know, when did I realize that they were obviously that beautiful? Everybody, you see them, and they're done. So, when you figure out that they are really meant for each other, though, you know, you got them like a Taco Bell, and everybody's still laughing, so I'll tell the story. I was gonna skip it if everyone didn't laugh, but they did, so there was. One night that I should probably tell everyone about, I thought it was over. You know, I sleep on the couch a lot. their couch, not mine. I don't own a couch, but they do. But you know, I help move it, whatever. So it was a fun night, whatever. All of a sudden, it got weird. So. It gets better, I promise. Sorry. So, we're hanging out. Great time. You know, really good tacos. It's been a great night. You know, we're having burritos. We're having quesadillas. And then Marissa threw a taco. And that's where the fun ended. Because she told me to go get the ham. And I'm like, well, you threw the taco, not me. Yeah, why should I go get him? That's your best friend. There's reverberation because it's not that funny of a story. I did have to go out and get him because she just sat there and ate the taco. Laughing because it's not that funny. If you were there, it's hilarious. But no, honestly, all jokes aside, I wanted to get all the jokes out first so that I could get the nerves out and all that. These are the two best people I've ever met in my life. You have two people that actually care about each other immensely and really do want to be with each other forever. And a taco's not going to stop them. Whether it's from the left or the right, Kirby's going to catch it. He's going to block it. That's my catcher, by the way. Awesome, dude. He blocks everything. But congratulations to them. Jackson, I think you got something for us. Because I already messed up, so I might as well keep it going. So,
oh, Lord.
So Mr. Mitchell.
Mr. Mitchell.
Is an awesome person. This guy, I can't believe he didn't cry from step one. His daughter shows up, she's beautiful. Obviously. Chris said yes. Good job. But there was a time when I finally realized that I could say whatever I wanted to at the wedding, and it wouldn't really matter, because I'm still going to walk around and tell me there's some children here, so no bad words. But where are the Mitchell Brothers? Mitchell Brothers! Mitchell Brothers, come on.
Right here.
Mitchell Brothers.
Rick,
Brandy, Ron. So Robert decided that he wasn't going to do this toast, and I felt that being the end of the night and
already messing up. He's like, oh, I would. You might as well do all this. So I think we've gotten to the point that Ron's got one. All of your brothers do have one. Doc?
Doc's got one.
If that.
Wit? You weren't there, but you know the story. So.
Ow!
I'm getting to the punchline, Haley. Do you want to come? So we're all hiding, you know, and obviously that's what Mitchell Brothers do, but I don't know what the point was, but Bud Light came out with this really cool ad campaign, and Robert forgot to do it. So if Mitchell Brothers, you would all stand up, please, please. Cheers to Mitchell Brothers. Cheers to the whole. We got two beautiful families here. Will be the one to mess it up. So, you crack your beers. Well, dilly dilly. Chris, in the penitentiary, run. So, sorry if I ruined your party, but. Yeah.